Oh, hey, what up? Seriously, guys, if you have not read Looking for Alaska by John Green, you need to read it because it, like everything else John Green related, is made of awesome! Seriously, guys, read this book.
Oh, hi there. Welcome to the Seriously Kitchen. Today we're going to be making a delectable treat called the Bufrido. I don't know if you remember, but Maureen made it for all of the students, and they thought it was delicious, and we think it's delicious, and you are going to think it's delicious. So, if you pay close attention, you're going to learn how to make a Bufrido in your own kitchen.
Well, hey there. This is a burrito from our local burrito place, Taco John's. And this is a steaming pot of oil, perfect for frying. When you put the oil in the pot, don't just stick the burrito in there and expect immediate frying action. You gotta wait for a little while, see some waves moving in the oil, and then you know that it's ready to just attack that burrito with all of its magical frying powers. Seriously, guys, wait for the oil to heat up.
Okay, so when you're making your little Bufridos here, you're gonna need a few utensils, as well as some equipment. The first thing that you're obviously going to need is the pan, which was shown earlier. But you will also need not one spatula, but two spatula. Spatulae? Let's go with that. You're going to need spatulae because oftentimes the Bufrido tortilla starts to kind of bubble up and you gotta make sure that it's staying in there. And then when you take it out, you definitely don't want to burn yourself. So just make sure you're using your little spatulae. Then you're going to need a knife. The knife is used to cut the Bufrido. As you can see, this is a butter knife. Those things are so darn good and so darn tender that you don't even need a sharp knife. You can cut it with a butter knife. Then, you're definitely going to need paper towels, because you're going to want to pat down the grease to make sure you're not putting too much into your system. I mean, I know these are meant to be artery cloggers, but do we really have to go all out? I don't think so. And finally, you're going to need your book, because when you're waiting for the little Bufrido to cook, you might want to read a few pages of this awesome novel. All right, here we go. We're going to take this nice, lovely burrito. And just a quick tip, I had to re-roll these burritos from Taco John's because they didn't do a very good job. So if your local burrito shop doesn't do a very good job of rolling them, make sure you re-roll them. Pretty much what you're going to want is a tight end on one side and a tight end on the other. And you're going to want it to be nice and stuck down. So that way, whenever you're putting in the oil, all of the filling doesn't come out. All right. Let's take this, and very easily, we're going to drop it, or rather, set it into the oil. Watch this. Nice, easy motion. And just kind of hold it down in there. Okay. And as you can see, it's starting to turn a nice golden brown color. Because this oil has been heating up for a while, it doesn't really take much time for this thing to get cooked. So, we're just going to roll it around a little bit. And if you plan on making more than one of these, make sure you pay close attention to your oil because it's going to start heating up. And after a while, you can really turn the heat off on the oil because your oil takes a long time to cool down. So you don't really need to worry about keeping it on. And that keeps it safe for you. Another tip is don't throw water in the oil ever, because that will cause a grease fire. And you know, we're seriously safe here in the Seriously Kitchen, so you should be safe in yours too. And as you can see, this really hasn't taken very long to cool down. I'm going to get my paper towel palette ready, so we can come over here. Just take one paper towel and fold it in half and set it down. And then we're going to come back over here. We're going to take our nice, yummy Bufrido and nice and easily move it over to the paper towel. And then you take a nice, another one and fold it and pat it down. All right, we're going to leave that there and let it cool down and we'll be back.
When you are finished making the awesome Bufrido, it should look something like this. See that beautiful golden brown color? It is delicious. And you have the option of garnishing it with salsa, or guacamole, or sour cream, or sugar, if you prefer, but that would be kind of nasty. Oh, and if you really are daring, you should wash this baby down with some bluefin. Check out our other video. Link in the enticed rhino spit.
Culinary orgasm.
Definitely.
You can say a lot of bad things about Alabama, but you can't say that Alabamans are people who are unduly afraid of deep fryers. In that first week of the Creek, the cafeteria served fried chicken, chicken fried steak, and fried okra, which marked my first foray into the delicacy that is the fried vegetable. I half expected them to fry the iceberg lettuce.